السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. شكر الحمد لله dengan taufik dan hidayah daripada hadrat Allah Subhanahu wa taala, kita as usual together semata-mata kerana Allah, nak cari ilmu Allah. Mudah-mudahan insyaallah Allah janji dalam surah Al-Hajj ayat 40 yang berbunyi man yansurannallaha falyansuruh. Barang siapa meninggikan kalimat la ilaha illallah, Allah akan meninggi nama dia. Dan kita ni muslimat dan muslimin yang saya hormat sekalian, kalau kita cari ilmu Al-Quran, kalau kita hadir majalisul ilmi untuk nak menguatkan iman kita, nak kuatkan agama kita, masuklah juga dalam golongan orang yang meninggikan kalimat la ilaha illallah. Allah janji dah, man yansurannallaha falyansuru innallaha laqawiyyun aziz. Sesungguhnya orang yang meninggikan kalimat la ilaha illallah, nak suruh orang kuat iman, nak suruh orang kuat agama, insyaallah Allah akan menguatkan mereka dan Allah akan maju jaya mereka. Dan saya rasa semua yang dalam majlis ni insyaallah masuk dalam golongan orang ini. Dan Allah janji kis apa? Inna Allah la qawiyun aziz. Allah maha kuat lagi maha perkasa. You try to meninggikan kalimah la ilaha illallah, buat something for religion, buat something to make people good Muslim, insyaallah Allah will give you all the victory all the way, insyaallah. Muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, iman kita ni kadang-kadang, you know, we are not sure your iman is kuat ke, lemah ke. That's why sometimes once and while you have to do also iman test. Iman test ni maknanya apa? You have to ask yourself few question to discover whether your iman ni strong iman or weak iman. Kadang-kadang kita ni Muslim, yes, but not necessarily mu'min. Not necessarily, because there is a lot of difference between iman and Islam. Islam is qawli. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu. Anyone say that is already Muslim. But mu'min is amalan qalbi, something with the heart, your belief, your really, you know, belief and the love to Allah, the sincerity to Allah. And you really don't want to do anything to make Allah unhappy with you. These are your people yang kita panggil apa? Mu'min. That's why dalam surah Al-Hujurat, Allah tegur some people by telling them what? La taqulu amanna, walakin qulu aslamna, walamma yadkhulil imanu fi qulubikum. Never claim you are a mu'min. You are just baru Muslim. Iman tak masuk dalam hati kamu lagi. Because there are some Bedouins who go and want to claim this, claim that with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and say to him, we are already mu'min, we are already like you. Allah said, don't say mu'min. You are baru Muslim. وَلَمَّا يَدُخْلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Iman tak masuk dalam hati kamu lagi. So today, our muqaddima, do some tests once and while for yourself to realize after this test, I am a mu'min or I just Muslim. Because there is a lot of difference between mu'min and Muslim. What are the symptoms that can show that your iman is lemah? There are few symptoms. We call it what? Tanda-tanda iman lemah. Number satu sekali, you are doing the maksiat, but you don't feel I'm doing maksiat. But you are doing it. And you are not worried at all. Become adat. Lying, talking about people, criticizing people, call people names. Minum maksiat lah. Mini-mini maksiat. You know, sembahyang, pakai pakaian yang belek-belek, tak kira halal haram. All this we call it maksiat and you don't feel it. This is a very tanda iman lemah. Number one, buat maksiat tapi tak rasa. Tak rasa apa. Some people buat the maksiat but you rasa, hey, I'm so sorry. Lama-lama saya mati, tak ada nak buat ini. Like, okay. Alhamdulillah, tahniah. Your heart is still alive. Ada harapan lagi lah. Tapi if you do it and you feel nothing, okay, what? Tak ada apa, then iman is really lemah lah. Okay. Number two, hati keras. Your heart is very keras. Tengok orang nangis pun, you tak rasa apa. Dengar orang mati pun, tak rasa apa. Pergi lalu kubur pun, tak rasa apa. Itu tanda iman. Dengar Quran pun, tak rasa apa. Ha, so, itu juga tanda iman lemah. Qaswatul qalbi. You just walk in the kubur as if you are just walking in between batu. That's all. You don't feel anything. That's why very some people masuk kubur rasa, oh my God, I'm coming here soon. Oh, what will happen to me inside there? Am I going to be in good place or bad place? They think a lot. This is standard. Hati hidup lagi, iman kuat. But some people don't feel anything. Kubur for them is just like passing by houses. Itu tanda iman lemah. Number tiga. You don't do the ibadah properly. Salat mulai istak sampai sudah tak tahu pun baca apa. Buat ibadah jadi adat. Bukan ibadah. Jadi adat. Itu tanda iman lemah. Adam itqan al-ibadah in Arabic. I don't do the ibadah in the proper way. Most of the time, I just salah because I have to pray. Not because I'm najah, I duduk cakap dengan Allah, with love, with kasih, with khushu'. I don't feel anything. I just pray. It becomes just something, you know, have to do it. Itu tanda iman lemah. Because you must know, Rasulullah SAW used to be what? Looking forward for the salah. Looking forward. Habis zuhur, tunggu asar. Habis asar, tunggu maghrib. And he used to say to Sayyidina Bilal, arihna bis salah ya Bilal. Please Bilal, I'm so tired, I want to be comfortable. Azan lah, I want to pray. Happy, happy for the prayer. So if you do the prayer, with just as, hey, I have to finish it. You know, I have to pray lah, I want to finish it. That's standard iman lemah. If you do looking forward to do it and you do it with quality, itu tanda iman kuat. Okay. Number empat. Very lazy to do the ibadah. Malas. Bila dengar kena puasa, malas. Bila dengar nak solat dah malas. That's why tanda orang munafik. Allah said in the Quran, وَإِذَا قَامُوا لِلصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَ بِلَّا نَأْصَلَى حَبِيسْ lazy. Very lazy. itu tanda iman lemah. Tidak kata happy-happy. Some people when they want to pray to prepare the place, pakai kantor, happy-happy, minyak-minyak atur. Nak jumpa dengan Allah ni. How you feel when you want to jumpa with your boyfriend before marriage? Or with your fiancé, or even with your husband. You are very happy, you dress up nicely. This one is Allah, you know. Nak jumpa dengan Allah, you know, no joke. Allah, the decider, the maker. And he decide, the provider, everything. Sebab kita tak berasa tu. Berasa biasa. Buat-buat. Itu very bad. Itu tanda iman lemah. Okay, number lima, very moody. Orang yang moody ni iman lemah, not stable. Not stable at all, sekali happy, sekali sad, sekali depressed, sekali very galak. Very typical of iman lemah. Because orang yang iman kuat ni, you see them stable all the way. Ada problem pun, okay. Tak ada problem pun, okay. stable. Tanda iman yang lemah, unstable. Very easily affected with any situation, ada change, hilan satu perkara ke, something happen ke, very annoyed, very sad, itu iman lemah. Kalau orang iman kuat, all this temporary. Very stable, very, very stable. Okay. Six, you don't feel anything when you read the Quran or when you hear the Quran. You see, I just come inside the house just now and to a room of the Quran. I feel my hair stand. I feel something. I feel sayu, I feel. So if you have this feeling, it's very, very good. If you hear the Quran, you don't feel anything. Some people hear the Quran, don't feel anything. Tapi hear biramli, air mata keluar. Di mana aku cari ganti? Habis. Air mata nak keluar dah. Tapi dengarlah Al-Quran, ayat siksa, ayat neraka, ayat syirik. Tak rasa apa. Itu tanda iman lemah. Okey, apa lagi? Ghaflah, lalai. لا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. سورة one of the surah. الله said what? لا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. Mereka ingat kata orang jarang-jarang ya. Itu and become what? Very lalai. And then number 11, you are not unhappy if people joke about Islam. People talk something bad about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People talk something bad about Muslims. You are not unhappy. You also joke with them. That's standard iman lemah. Kalau orang iman kuat, anyone say anything bad, don't. No lah. It's not true. Itu very good lah. That means you really defend Islam, defend Muslims. If the iman lemah, you take it as a joke lah. People talk anything, you won't joke, no problem. Nine. You like to show off. Very, very fond of show off. My house like this, like this. My car like that, like that. I owe this, I owe that. All this, I buy cash. Someone bujur, I have one more. Di gini, gini. It like to show off. Itu iman lemah. 10, very stingy. Very, very stingy. Is a very tanda of iman lemah. Rasulullah SAW said what? لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد المؤمن الإيمان والبخل. Impossible to have two things in one heart. مؤمن and بخيل. Impossible. The مؤمن must be very generous. Don't care, you know, because you know very well Allah yang bagi, Allah yang tarik, serah kepada Allah, insyaAllah money won't come from Allah. If Allah nak bagi, bagi. Allah tak nak bagi, tak ada rezeki from Allah. You are very mudah kira lah. Orang yang banyak kira ni, berkira sangat ni, stingy means iman lemah. Okay, number 11, cakap tak bikin. You talk, but you don't do what you talk. Cakap tak bikin. Itu very, very bad and show that iman is lemah. Dan Allah tegur dalam surah As-Saff, ayat 2, ayat 3, ayat 4. Allah said what? Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. Wahai orang beriman, jangan cakap yang tak bikin. Talk so much, but tak buat. Cakap saja. This, that, tapi tak buat. And of course, Muslimin yang saya hormat sekalian, Muslimin dan Muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, you are so happy when you hear something bad happen to your saudara Muslim. Especially if you don't like that person. And you hear something bad happen to him, you are very happy. Itu iman lemah. If the iman is kuat, even so he is your musuh. Even so you don't like the person. But you hear something bad happened to him. Allah kesian ke dia. I hope Allah give her sabar. I hope kesian ke dia. I hope pity her or pity him. Tapi baca muka. Yes. How now? Itu very bad. Itu iman lemah. Kalau orang hati baik, iman kuat. Oh, kesian dia. Why? I hope she will be okay. I hope Allah give her the sabar. I hope Allah help her. Okay. Number 13. You don't care about the small dosa. Even the makruh, you know Rasulullah SAW said, misalnya makruh, kita muluk, kita kuat-kuat makan buah putih. Makruh kalau kita salam sama orang. Or cakap orang tu bau betai, bau bawang putih, misalnya makruh, I don't care, makan juga, cakap juga depan orang. Itu iman lemah. Because if orang iman kuat, even the makruh pun I don't do. I try my best. I eat, yes, bawang putih, I eat, yes, betai, sedap. Tapi after that, I take chewing gum ke, I do spray my mouth ke. Because Nabi kata, mulut kita bau busuk, orang bau is makruh. Ha, bibul orang lemah, they don't care. Ha, bukan saja mulut busuk, tangan busuk pun, they don't care. Salam, bau ikan lagi, bau makan, they don't care. Ha, so, anything makruh, it become haram if it's too many makruh. So, be careful. If orang yang iman kuat, small makruh ni pun, I don't like because it can be big one. The small dosa can lead to a big dosa. Okay. Now, number 14. You, ihtiqarul ma'ruf means what? Benda kici-kici. Like for example, Rasulullah SAW said, you jumpa orang senyum. You jumpa orang kata assalamu alaikum. You underestimate all that. Benda kecil ya, tak apa. I don't do it, apa. That means what? Your iman is lemah. Kalau orang iman kuat, sami'na wa ata'na. Nabi kata, jumpa orang senyum, I straight away senyum. Jumpa orang kata salamu alaikum, I salamu alaikum. So, you small things, you don't give a damn. You always say, never mind lah, it's a small matter. It's not, no, if you are iman kuat, small matter pun, I take it serious. Why can't I do what Nabi suruh? I see people, apa salahnya? Assalamualaikum. I see you. Because all this you are collecting mahala. Okay? Baik. Number 15. You don't care about what happening to your Muslim saudara. You don't care. You don't care. You know, like for example now, we hear what is happening in Palestine. But we don't care, we don't dua, we don't, you know, take action. You know, we don't arrange something to help them. Or even our Muslim inside our country, someone in trouble financially and come and talk to loan, we don't care. Ha, tidak kata ambil serius, yang ke so-and-so. Ha, dia minta tolong saya, but I cannot help. Come, we do something to help her. If orang kuat iman, they will do that. If orang iman lemah, I don't care lah. Dia, saya. Because we in Muslim, Rasulullah said what? Al-Muslimu lil-Muslimi kal-bunyan yashuddu ba'duhu ba'da. Orang Islam sama orang Islam ni seperti bangunan. Mesti bersatu. Kalau satu anggota dalam bangunan ni lemah, the whole bangunan will jatuh. So we should help each other, love each other, care for each other. If you are not having this feeling, your iman is lemah. Okay. Apa lagi? Of course, tak berapa cara silatul rahim. You are married, you have your husband, you have your children. Forget about your adik-beradik, forget about your mak saudara, forget about bapak saudara. Silatul rahim ni is not existing. Padahal Rasulullah said what? Man aradallahu an yazida fi rizqih wa yubarik fi umri fal yasir rahimah. Barang siapa nak murah rizki, ha? Nak Allah panjangkan umur dia, silaturrahimlah banyak-banyak. Ha, so if your iman is kuat, you must do that. Silaturrahim ti very important. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said what? Man qata'ahu qata'ani wa man wasalahu wasalani. Barang siapa silaturrahim seperti silaturrahim dengan aku. Barang siapa betul silaturrahim, dia betul dengan aku. La yadkhulu al-jannata qati'. Tidak masuk syurga orang yang betul silaturrahim. You must find out about your relative, your adik beradik, your, you know, kerabat. Because silaturrahim ni very important to prove you are what? I am a mu'min. Okay. Of course, number 17. You very takut and very sedih bila ada musibah. Masya Allah. Very depressed, very sad, very scared bila ada musibah. You can see here the difference between the good mu'min and between the iman yang lemah. Kalau orang good mu'min, tenang. La khawfun alaihim wa la hum yahzanun. Padahal musibah berlaku. I notice some Malays are very good in iman when there is musibah. When I see, for example, I was looking at the TV few days back, the man telling about his son, he want to go back to KL. He decided not to go to KL. Night masuk bilik, and he died with the 3 children and a wife. One whole family, husband, wife, 3 children. They went for Hari Raya Haji Kurban. And the father said, well, they're not balik. He was telling the TV, Bibullah, they're not balik. Tapi dia kata, ayah, saya nak duduk satu hari lagi. Nak makan kucau goreng mana, buk mak apa, tak tahu. Saya pun pergi belilah kucau goreng itu. Dia makan, he is saying it while he is smiling. Masya Allah. He lost the son, the wife, and 3 cucu. And yet he is telling the story very tenang. Kalau orang yang tak ada iman. No. Very good mu'min. I admire people like that. Very stable, sing it nicely. Dia nak balik tapi tak jadi balik. Dan inilah berlaku. Qadar dan qadar nak buat macam mana. Masya Allah. So, react to the musibah ni. How you react can show your iman. If you react to the musibah in a very stable way, tenang, tak merajuk, your iman is strong. If you react to the musibah with merajuk, with unhappy, with crying, itu iman lemah. Okay, number 11. Of course, suka bantah-bantahan, suka argue with people. Orang yang iman kuat ni, dia tak argue. Al-jidal. Jidal means what? Like to argue with people. Always like to win. Kalau orang iman kuat, never mind lah, I give my opinion. You accept, you don't accept, up to you lah, but this is my opinion. And you see them while they are talking also, not in angry mood. Very stable. Itu iman kuat. Ya ke? Maybe lah. But I thought that this like that, because I learn or I know that it is like that, so I don't know lah. Tak apa lah. No. You tak betul. Saya tahu. You tak tahu. Itu iman lemah lah. Iman lemah. Okay. And you must know Muslimin dan Muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian. Ana Rasulullah SAW said what? Ana za'imu baitin fil jannah liman taraka al-jidal walau kana haqqa. Beautiful this hadith. I am a leader to an house in heaven for those who don't argue walaupun they are the right people, but they don't argue. Ma'nani apa? You'll be in that house with Rasulullah SAW. You know you are right. You are very sure you are right. Like a friend of you, for example, kata, you never call me. You never call me in the phone. He said, ya Allah. I call you many times. You never call. And you know you call her. I call you. I really call you, but no, you don't call me, you don't call. Tak apalah, I didn't call you, okay lah. But if you keep on like, no, I can't go, I call you. Itu like to argue lah, okay? Like to argue. So Rasulullah said what? أنا زعيم بيت في الجنة لمن ترك الجدال ولو كان حقا. I am a leader of a house in heaven to those who don't do bantah-bantahan walaupun they are right. But they don't do, okay lah. I didn't call, okay lah. Nak buat macam mana? Okay. Of course, number 19, hubb dunia. You are so much fond of dunya, thinking of dunya all the time. 5 years lagi, this money will be like this. 2 tahun lagi, if I put it will be like that. If I buy this, will be like that. All your fikiran is what? Dunya. Itu tanda iman lemah. Tanda iman lemah. You also must, if I do this, will go to my book of amalani in akhirah. Allah will give me 2 juratus kaliganda. These are the iman kuat lah. But iman yang lemah ni, never think of akhirah. Always thinking of dunia. Okay. Akhir sekali, muslimin dan muslimah yang saya hormati sekalian. Your lifestyle, very western. Even when you tkejuk bon, you don't say Allahu Akbar. Oh my God, oh God. Ya Masha Allah. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. So the style of life too is too western. Itu tanda iman lemah. The way you talk, the way you comment, the way you joke, very un-Islamic. We are Muslim, behave like a Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ajar kita ajaran Nabi kena jalan. Bila Nabi kata, bila kita terkejut, Allahu Akbar. Bila kita misalnya ada musibah, la hawla wa la quwata illa billah alil azim. All this, your Islamic behavior ni can show your iman is what. Tengok benda cantik, subhanallah. Belik ni, benda ni tengok belik benar ni. Belik lah. What is this? You must have the comment that, you know, show that you appreciate Islamically, from the Islamic point of view, by mentioning Allah in the way you talk. Okay? And of course, the last one, 21, too much exaggerating the way you dress up, the way you berhias your house, the way you berhias your car, too much exaggerating. Itu tanda iman yang lemah. Exaggerate, over. Pakai bon, 4-5 gelang sekali. Waktu kalau rantai, 4-5 rantai sekali. Waktu kalau ada brush sini satu. Itu teruk sangatlah. Al-mughala, we call it mughala. Over dress, overdoing. Barakallahu fiik. Overdoing in the house, overdoing in the way you dress up, overdoing in berhiasan, overdoing in makanan. Everything over, that shows that iman is not. We are what? Ummah wasata. Rasulullah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. Umma Nabi Muhammad ni ummah sederhana. Not over exaggerating and not over also itu. Sederhana, insyaAllah. Itulah muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, tanda iman lemah. And why? What make our iman lemah? What are the reasons that can make anyone his iman lemah? You are very far from iman atmosphere. The way you grow up, the way you behave, you the surrounding. The circle of friends you have. That's why Rasulullah SAW said, you must choose good friends and you must have a good parents. Parents need have to be good parents. It has to be before marriage, like The man choose a good Muslima, the Muslima choose a good man. So if the person far from all this, his iman is not strong. Okay? You don't have a good role model. You see, our role model is who? Ayah, Ibu. If Ayah, Ibu not a good role model, you cannot blame the generation. You see, kita semenjak budak lagi sampai tua, nampak arwah ayah, bin ibu kita sebagai berjamaah. So it already come to your head. My late father selalu recite the Quran. My late mother selalu pray with my father berjamaah. My late father always wake us up for subuh. My late mother always advise. So the role model should be important to make the iman of the young generation is strong. Okay? And of course, so far from ilum sharia. You see, you go to any houses, you will find all the books, how to decorate the house, how to arrange flowers, how to this, how to... But buku agama, maybe nowadays lah, baru started. Tapi dulu, tak ada. Alam barzakh, akhirat, hisab, something about sharia. So, if the person don't have all this, the iman will be lemah. The way we grow up, the way the atmosphere around us is very important to increase our iman. And of course, tambah lagi a big problem if you are surrounded with people who do maksiat. That can make iman very lemah. All my friends maksiat, my husband bone, my krabat, my relatives, that can make the iman lemah. Okay? And of course, very busy with dunia. Buka mata bagi-bagi tak ada kerja lain. Business, mesyuarat, business, deal, project. You don't have time for Allah. You don't have time for akhirat. That can make your iman lemah. But like what we are doing now, at least every week once we get the dose to make our iman strong, this helps us a lot. Kalau kita completely far from all this, you forget yourself. And Allah already said what? Dalam surah Al-Hashr. نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم. Some people completely forget about Allah. Somebody Allah make them forget themselves. والعياذ بالله. Don't reach to that stage. You forget completely about Allah, Allah make you forget yourself. Terlibat dengan dosa tak berasa. Very busy with dunia. والعياذ بالله. And of course, what is the tanda of حب الدنيا? What is the tanda that you are in love so much with dunia? جمود العين. Mata tak berapa menangis. Dengar orang mati tak sedih. Dengar orang susah tak rasa kesian ke dia. Mata sudah keras. Hati pun sudah keras. Qaswatul qalb. Rasulullah said, these are the tanda-tanda of orang suka dunia. Mata keras, hati keras, banyak rancangan for the dunia ni. 20 years lagi, if I buy this, 20 years lagi will be that much. If I do this, 10 years lagi will be that much. That will make you very, very keras hati. Because you so much rancangan for dunia ni. Okay? And of course, another thing can make us iman lemah. Another physical things. Makan too much. Sleep too much. Wake up at night so much. Tidur pukul 3, tidur pukul 4. This make iman lemah. Because when you tidur that time, tak bangun subuh. And the whole day tired. Sometimes even tidur sampai tak sebayan zuhur. The night become day, the day become night. Don't do that. Allah already say in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. Siang untuk cari rezeki, malam untuk tidur. So, makan banyak, tidur banyak, duduk stay too long at night, lama. All this can weaken your iman. Akhir sekali, which can weaken our iman, ketawa banyak. Banyak ketawa. Sikit-sikit. very dangerous. رسول الله said, إياكم وكثرة الضحك. جانا كتاوة بنيا بنيا فإن كثرة الضحك تميت القلب. كتاوة بنيا بنيا ني وليه ماتي هاتي. You're not serious anymore. هاتي ماتي. سيكي سيكي ها ها. And you are very fond of people who can make you laugh. Very fond of them. Make you laugh. Always kitawa, always joke. So this can make what? Iman jadi lemah. Kerana itu muslimin dan muslimat, you check yourself once in a while because kita masuk syurga dengan hati. And iman tu amalan dalam hati. Because if your iman is strong, your heart full of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will never be sad, you will never be scared. You are very, very composed all the time. You are a very strong person. You are not moody. You are not moody at all. You are not demanding. You are not greedy. You are tawakkal. You are sabar. You are shukur. Itulah iman yang kuat. InsyaAllah.